Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. In today's video, we are going to prove an identity using mathematical induction. Okay, and that's the identity right here. So we want to show for all n element of the natural numbers, including zero, that this identity holds. So that means x to some odd power plus one can always be divided, factorized into some x plus one times a sum. Okay, Why is this important? Well, I'm doing a series on the integrals of the form 1 over x to the nth power plus 1. So every time I'm encountering an odd n, I'm going to use this to factorize this whole expression. So this is pretty useful and we are going to use it sometimes. Okay, so mathematical induction. What are we going to start with? We are going to start with the base step. We are including zero, so our base step means that we set n equals to zero. Okay, so I'm going to say this is the base step. This doesn't mean bullshit, it's base step. Okay, so n equals to zero. What would that mean? So we can just plug this in. So that's x to the 2 times 0 plus 1th power plus 1. And all in all, this is just x plus 1. Okay, and now we are going to plug 0 into here. So this is equal to x plus 1 times the sum from k equals to 0 to 0, okay, of minus 1 to the times x to the kth power. Okay, so this index goes from 0 to 0. That means it's just minus 1 to the 0th power times k to the 0th power, and this is just 1. So all in all, it's just x plus 1. And you can see this is definitely true, I guess. Okay, next thing, we are going to tell what our inductive hypothesis is. So it's up right here. I'm not going to write it again. You see what it is. I already explained it. And now let's start with the inductive step, the most difficult part. It's not really difficult, it's pretty trivial, but still. Okay, and that means we want to show that n implies n plus 1. Okay, how are we going to do this? We are going to use a little trick. We are going to play around with the algebra. We are going to multiply x squared on both sides. Okay. So let's start off with this little idea. So we are going to start off by saying x to the 2n plus 1th power plus 1 times x squared. Okay, what is this equal to? We are just going to distribute it right now. So this is x to the 2n plus 3. I hope you agree with me that we can do this. Plus x squared. Okay, What next? Remember, we want to bring the expression right here into the form of the regular expression that we want to show. Okay, so we need a 1 here, a plus 1. How do we get that? Maybe we could add a 1 and then subtract a 1. And I hope you agree with me that we can add 0 and that won't change nothing. Okay, good. So let's say this is the same as x to the 2n plus 3 power plus 1 minus, I'm going to write it in a little bit different way, minus x squared plus 1. And you will see later why I'm doing this. Okay, we can do that. That's still a valid observation. Okay, and now we are going to multiply x squared on the right side. Okay, so this is equal to x plus 1 times the sum from k equals to 0 to 2n of minus 1 to the kth power times x to the kth power times x squared. And now we can distribute this x squared into here. Okay, so this is x plus 1 times the sum from k equals to 0 to 2n of minus 1 to the kth power times x to the k plus 2 power. Okay, next step, we are going to add this term on both sides. Okay, and maybe you can already see where I'm going. So this is equivalent to, okay, so we've got this one right here, so that's x to the 2, and we are going to bring this expression into this form right here. So that's 2 times n plus 1 plus 1. This is still true. Plus 1. Okay. And like I said, we are going to add this expression on both sides. So this is equal to x plus 1 times the sum from k equals to 0 to 2n of minus 1 to the k of power times x to the k plus 2 power, plus 1 minus x squared. And the good thing is, right now, as this term is, we can't do anything with it right now. But you may see that this is just the difference of two squares. So we can transform this a bit. So this bad boy is equal to 1 minus x times 1 plus x. And I hope you can see where I'm going, because we have the same factor right here, x plus 1, and I'm crossing my arms right now. Isn't that absolutely astonishing? Okay, so we got the same factor and we can factor this out. So let's do this. So this is equal to x plus 1 times, okay, now the sum from k equals to 0 to 2n of minus 1 to the k of power times x to the k plus 2 power. And now we've got this expression. So plus 1 minus x. Okay. And now we are just going to write this out a bit with the first and the last terms. At this point, we could just work with the index right here and we can move it around a bit, but to make it a bit more clear where this last step comes from, I'm going to write it out like I said before. Okay, so this expression on the right is equal to x plus 1, okay, times. And we are going to start off with the highest limit up here. So if we plug in 2n, so that's minus 1 to an even power, so that's just positive 1. And right here it's x to the 2n plus 2 power. Okay, now it's 2n minus 1. Okay, that's an odd power, so this becomes a negative sign times x to the 2n plus 1 power. Okay, then it's alternating between plus and minus 1, so dot dot dot, and then minus. Okay, now we are at the last two steps. So k equals to 1, that's minus 1 to an odd power, so that's a negative sign, okay? And we've got 1, so that's x to the third power. Okay, and if we plug in 0, so that's a positive sign, like I said, it's alternating, and then it's just x to the second power. Okay, and now we just have those two terms left, so that's minus x plus 1. And as you might see, that's the same sum as before, but it goes from 0 to 2n plus 2. Okay, keep that in mind. So this is x plus 1 times the sum from k equals to 0 to 2n plus 2 of minus 1, it's the alternating, to the k of power times x to the k of power. Okay, and how is this useful? Well, we can factor out n plus 1 right here. So all in all, this expression right here is equal to x plus 1 times the sum from k equals to 0 to 2 times n plus 1 plus 1. 2 times n plus 1, I'm sorry. Okay, the sum of minus 1 to the k of power times x to the k of power. And this is indeed what we wanted to show in the beginning. So I can place this little, I proved this square right here. And yeah, we have proven this one using mathematical induction. And it's such a nice way. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions about this procedure, just leave some comments. if you like this video, please like and subscribe and recommend me if you want. And I wish you a fabulous day. See ya.
Hallo Mama.